That's gluten free. What type of shit? Never in my life, nigga. Never in my life.
Hey, so what's up, AD? What's the bad signal?
Say what?
We gotta have a bad signal. We can jump Ricky when he's talking shit.
Ricky, I don't know what the fuck.
Oh no, it's just been fun and entertaining. I'm getting in his head, rent free.
Seem like you're there already. You say it look like you're there. You there already. I'm saying he was die hard not playing Apex with you the other day, and then he played Apex with you just yesterday, so I'm like, shit, you there. Yeah, I ain't never heard of no orange pranks. I don't know what the hell. Assume it's a fruit named after a color. I assume the color had to come first.
No, because orange is actually not a natural color.
No, I know it's not. But
so that means the fruit will have to have come first. Because orange was always there.
I mean, you don't think they had orange skies?
Hey, AD, where are you at right now?
I'm on Horizon.
Name Horizon?
Yeah.
Are you able to pause it?
I'm live streaming, but what? What you want? Can't you just upload it to what you call them? I mean, I can. Oh.
You playing Horizon on your PlayStation?
Yup. That's what I got it on. I had a follow up joke to that, but it was going to be questionable.
I don't agree with you. I put it in Richie's
server. Oh, I see it.
Okay.
feels to hide behind. Your kit doesn't allow you to ever lose a 1v1, but you somehow find a way to anyways. You never use your ultimate except when you want to cut yourself off from your enemy or you completely miss it. You're either playing Gibraltar because you're in chat, feels like it, or because your teammates have been begging you to. You watch big streamers pick Ryzen in ranked as they're running through gold and platinum players, and you keep thinking that this will work for you as well. You can't get a squad wipe to save your life, so you rely on your ultimate and a stack of grenades to do it for you. You might be a movement fiend looking for movement slides. You probably have gone deaf with at least one ear from all the Ryzen voice lines. If you play Lifeline, you probably just started playing the game, or you're playing with a set of friends who are better or more experienced. Your playstyle consists of following everyone else like a lost puppy and beelining to revive your teammates as soon as they go down, no matter what's going on around you. Probably such a pity, especially if you have a default Lifeline skin. If you play Lova, you play the game with one hand. And I mean that in all the ways. It's the only thing that you care about to the point where you will drop across the map and spend the entire game looting every single POI with your ultimate until you finally die to the first team you run into. It's very likely that you will let your teammates die just so you'll find yourself a golden sniper magazine. Oh yeah, and by the way, I've said this time and time again, I will not be apologizing to the Lova news community. If you play Mirage, you enjoy making outplays, but you're not exactly sure what an outplay actually is. You pick the legend that's designed around tricking your enemies, because tricking means outplays, right? Also, you expect your ultimate to be a good player, but you're going to trick yourself away and instantly get beamed and pretend.
Wait, what? I'm still watching this video. I slightly agree with everything that he said.
You said, right?
I slightly agree with everything that he said.
For the most part. Oh. What didn't you agree with?
Oh, the shit about Lifeline.
Oh, that you just started playing.
Yeah. Barney and Friends shit.
Talk. The sky plan's better.
Oh, Selena left. Damn. Well, that was...
Stick to cover! Archers on the ridge!
Giving up.
Hey,
Outlander.
Granted.
Me. Your time is
regenerated. Turn. Come down here and face me!
No! It was an honorable challenge. You've earned your life today. Comrades! Mark this day! Today you have decimated the Marshals! Slaughtered the Karja! So begins our war on Hikaru.
Yeah!
Hoorah!
Get him to the camp. Now.
You gonna make it?
You're going on without me, aren't you? Guess I'm stuck with Aaron. For now.
Come on. I'll take you back to the fort.
It's salvage time, boys.
I don't think it can take a hit. I should be able to use it to glide.
Aloy. We're still trying to sort out this mess. Seems like the Tanakh have a civil war in their hands.
That sounds about right. The Marshals weren't expecting Regala to attack.
And the entire Karja delegation was slain. Nozar, Vuadis, Fashav. A massacre. What will you do now?
I have to head west. Hopefully this rite of passage is still good. For what I'm after, I'll cross all of Tanakh's territory if I have to.
Then you have a long road ahead of you. This is only the threshold of the Forbidden West. The Tanakh's true domain lies over the mountains that border Plainsong, home of the Utaru tribe.
This isn't Tanakh's territory?
All that out there? That's no man's land. It was supposed to be neutral ground. Though, Obviously, this Regala ignored that. Her rebels approached from the north. With all those machines they were riding, they must have made camp up that way.
The rebels were riding bristlebacks. And there were bristlebacks in the Daunt.
Are you saying the rebels let them into the Daunt? How would that even be possible?
I don't know. But it's worth looking into.
While you're at it, there were a number of Karja and Osiram who went out there before the gates were shut for the embassy. Maybe you could check in on them. See if they're all right.
I can keep an eye out. Is there a tall neck somewhere nearby?
A tall neck? There's that one, over there, near the Utara border. But why...
It's hard to explain. It'll help me get the lay of the land.
If you say so. Is there anything else I can tell you before you go?